Hello, scientists. My name is Dr. Audra Huffmeyer, and I'm a biologist at the University of California, Los Angeles. Today, I'm going to talk about light-dependent reactions of photosynthesis to understand how plants capture energy from the sun. At the end of this video, you will understand the steps involved in photosynthesis, the products of photosynthesis, and the difference between photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. In grade school, we learned that plants use energy from the sun to make food. This is called photosynthesis. But did you know that bacteria can also capture energy from the sun and make food via photosynthesis? These bacteria are called cyanobacteria. They do not have chloroplasts, the structure in plants that contain chlorophylls that is necessary for photosynthesis. But they do have chlorophyll in their membrane folds that allow them to engage in photosynthesis. For example, blue-green algae that is found in the ocean is actually a bacteria. If we want to characterize it correctly, it is a cyanobacteria that has chlorophyll and is able to photosynthesize just like plants. Let's learn more about plants and cyanobacteria and how they photosynthesize. There are light-dependent and light-independent reactions of photosynthesis. Light-dependent reactions require a steady stream of sunlight, and there are four steps in light-dependent photosynthesis. The first is light absorption and photosystem 2. Light is absorbed by the chlorophylls that are found in the thylakoids of chloroplasts. The light energy is actually absorbed by photosystem 2, which is a multi-protein complex that contains different types of chlorophylls. When the light is absorbed, it excites an electron that is passed on to an acceptor molecule and is replaced with an electron from water. This reaction is actually the splitting of water and releases O2, the air we breathe. The second step is ATP synthesis. ATP is generated by an electron transport chain via the high energy electron. The third step is light absorption and photosystem 1. The electron now arrives at photosystem 1. When light hits the photosystem, the electron is excited again, and the high energy electron is transferred to an acceptor molecule. The fourth step is NADPH formation. NADPH is generated by an electron transport chain via the high energy electron. The goal of light-dependent reactions is to turn sunlight into ATP and NADPH that will be used in the light-independent reactions. The light-independent reactions, also known as the Calvin cycle, is a pathway where ATP and NADPH molecules are used to create glucose. Remember that photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 are multi-protein complexes that contain different types of chlorophylls that absorb different wavelengths of light. Photosystem 1 tends to absorb longer wavelengths of light, and photosystem 2 absorbs shorter wavelengths of light. So before we end, I want to check your understanding by doing a quick exercise. What is the difference between light-dependent reactions and the Calvin cycle? Great job. The first part of photosynthesis, light-dependent reactions, requires a steady stream of sunlight, while the Calvin cycle requires no light at all. To recap, you should now know the steps involved in photosynthesis are light absorption by photosystem 2, ATP synthesis, light absorption in photosystem 1, and NADPH synthesis. The products of photosynthesis are ATP and NADPH, and photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 absorb different wavelengths of light. Thank you, scientists, for following along today. I encourage you to keep watching and keep learning.